Students, today we will discuss exercise of chapter 1, the Indian subcontinent and history. So, your first question is, what is history? You have to mark with the pencil in your textbook. So, keep your textbook ready. The first answer is given on page number 1. History is a coherent account of the significant past events in the progress of human culture. Can you see it? Page number 1. Let us move on to the question number 2, which is on page number 2, where the human settlements flourish. Here you will write 1.1, 1.2. Human settlements have flourished wherever the means of living are plentiful. Let us move on to 1.3. Where do people in the hilly region depend on for their food? The answer is given on page number 1. Naturally, till for their food. Can you see it? Page number 1. Now let us move on to the question number 4. Which is the earliest civilization? Children, in this slide I have written the answer. So you will copy down same thing in the copy. Which is the earliest civilization? The earliest civilization in India is Harappan civilization. Can you see it? The earliest civilization in India is Harappan civilization. So copy down the same thing in the copy. Let us move on to the question number 2. Answer the following question in short. Write down while marking 2.1 and the question is on page number 1. What does human life depend on? Our diet, clothing, housing, occupation, till, geographical characteristics. Write down 2.1. The answer is on page number 1. Now 2.2. What features of our surroundings form the means of livelihood? The answer is on page number 2. Write down 2.2. The climate, rainfall, agricultural produce, till, livelihood. Let us move on to 2.3. Which region is known as the Indian subcontinent? The answer is on page number 5. From Afghanistan till Indian subcontinent is 2.3. Are you getting it? Now let us move on to the give reason. The first give reason is written as G.1, that is give reason 1. There is a close relation between history and geography. The answer is given on page number 1. Time, place, society and individuals are the four major pillars of history is the first answer. And below that, there is a close relation between history and geography answer is given. You have to continue. Time, place, society, till, geography are inseparable. Don't get confused. Time, place, society and individual are the four pillars of history, till, geography are inseparable. This is give reason 1. Give reason 2. G.2. People are forced to leave their settlements. The answer is given on page number 2. Sometimes, like the degradation of till, leave their settlements. Sometimes the reasons like degradation of the environment, drought, invasion, till to leave their settlements. Got it? Now, children, please listen carefully. There is a map of India showing Deccan Plateau, Thar Desert and everything in your textbook. Now, what you are supposed to do is you have to paste 4 Xerox copies of the map on 4 different pages. In the first map, you will show only Thar Desert. You will highlight only Thar Desert. In the second map, you will show peninsula, that is Deccan Plateau. If you see my earlier video, you will come to know how I have marked it. In the third map, you will show rivers, Sindhu, Ganga and Brahmaputra. And on the fourth map, you will mark islands. So, the things are very clear to you. You have to complete your work till Thursday. On Thursday, we will start with the new lesson. Till then, thank you and bye-bye, children.